Hello and welcome back. So in this video, we'll talk more about the Sequelize seeders with the previous example of user task and context. So this was the example we were talking about user and task and context. So when we write migrations, there is also a seeder. Seeder is actually used to seed the data, and the syntax look like same. Here we have up and down. In the we actually add the data in the system using bulk insert. So here we will use bulk insert, bulk update, all these utility we will use on query interface object to insert the bulk data from some JSON object, right? After that, how we define these models? Models you can create from the command line also, like we are creating the migrations, but models are also plain objects only. So like here I have created the user model. User model is nothing but sequelize.define user, and here you just specify all the attributes. Then class methods that contains associate. So here you need to define your associations of user with any other table. Like here user has many, user.belongs to, user has one, user has many. All these are actually tags which you need to put in the models class, model object, so that while you do the query, your Sequelize objects knows the relationship with any other object. So here we are doing user has many means user has many context, means use one user can have multiple context available. And here you can also specify the foreign key from the user table to the context table. So user as a primary key in the user table can be a part of the foreign key in multiple context rows. Okay, so here this is the relationship we are talking about, that user has many contexts, context can have only one user, context can have multiple tasks, one task can belong to one context only. So this, when we talk about in the code, it looks similar, right? So we have already seen these models, but now these models will not populate the data in the database until unless we don't put this flag as a true, because it will just drop the database and will create the relationship for you. So we wanted to keep it as a false, and what we wanted to do, we will create the relationship from the associations. So we can create a new migration. I'm lazy while writing. So just put your migration name, migration generate, name is what you can say. User associations, so you can see user associations has been created. Here we will define actually the relationship of user with the task. User has many task, or user has many user has many context, context has multiple tasks, one task belongs to a context, one single context belongs to a user. So I mean, we need to do this alterations using Sequelize only query interface. So return query interface dot add column, and here you need to pass the object of what you are going to add. So here you will be here you will have a mapping like table name. Table name is like, first of all, context. In the context, what you wanted to add, you wanted to add a user ID, which is a foreign key. Okay, and here you will define the properties. I mean, what all cascade update, cascade delete, all these properties you will be defining here only. Okay, so we can just take a look on to a simple example. So we can complete that associations. So this is how we define the associations. So let's put this here, query interface dot change column. I think we got everything required. So query interface dot add column, in the context what we are doing, we are adding user ID. Okay, because we, in the model we have already defined the user ID, so same you can use in the associations. In the context we are adding user ID, its type integer. Now here you need to pass the reference. So like we have seen, we can just take the reference. This is the order and customer ID, right? Customers, and so which model it belongs to, you need to pass here. So it belongs to user, and there it is being referred as the ID as a primary key. That we are using user ID as a foreign key in the context table. I can just check if it is a context or something else. Contexts with S. So try to just take care of all these naming, user ID. And once this is done, you can also do the chaining here. Dot then. This is the beauty of Sequelize, that you can perform the complete chaining. And here also you can add something, whatever you want, like query interface dot add column. So if there is any other relationship you wanted to define. So we have context to task, right? So in the task, I wanted to define context ID. Context ID. So context ID is from context table, and it is ID is a foreign key. So in the context, ID as a primary key will act as a foreign key with the name context ID in the task. Okay, so we got the relationship with the context with the user ID, and similarly task with context ID. Task will have a context ID, context will have a user ID. And when you wanted to do a down operation, down operation is nothing but here you will just do totally reverse of it. Query interface dot remove column. So when you do up, so there is a downside of it. I mean, you need to just return remove column. That is enough. So that you need to put in the down, because it will help in the undo operations. Sequelize DB migration undo. In that case, it will get executed, and what it is doing, from the context table, remove the user ID, and then similarly there is a chain. There is another operation which you need to do is return query interface dot remove column, and what column you wanted to remove? Context ID from the task. Right, see the beauty how we are actually chaining the things from one Sequelize. So I created a three tables. Now I'm defining all the associations inside a single Sequelize migration file, right? So you can do the chaining of that user context will have a user ID, task will have a context ID. What else we have? That's it, I think. And we can remove the column, so it will define the relationship. So when you run npm, sorry, Sequelize db migrate, it will run all the migrations.